Sierra Nevada Corporation's space plane called Dream Chaser. Sierra Nevada intends to perform its obligations under commercial resupply services using its new Dream Chaser space plane, a privately developed space shuttle, but only one quarter the size of the space shuttle, that will launch into orbit atop a rocket, make its delivery, then land back on Earth under its own power like an airplane. Sierra Nevada Corporation has already completed production of many critical parts of Dream Chaser, and last month, Dream Chaser passed another key milestone. Dubbed Integration Review 4, this latest test evaluated the space plane's design and its integrated performance with launch, ground and flight elements, and concluded that the Dream Chaser program was ready to move to full-scale spacecraft manufacturing and testing, with a likely introduction into service by late 2020. Dream Chaser is designed to be reusable, with a service life of 15 missions. In this regard, the Sierra Nevada Corporation is similar to SpaceX, which sends cargo to International Space Station aboard reusable Dragon space capsules launched into orbit by also reusable Falcon rockets. Utilizing reusable spacecraft, both Sierra Nevada Corporation and SpaceX should be able to save considerably on the cost of their missions, because they will not need to build new spacecraft for each supply run. In contrast, Northrop Grumman performs its International Space Station resupply missions using disposable Cygnus cargo capsules carried by expendable Antares rockets, likely a more expensive proposition. How Sierra Nevada could work even more cheaply. There's one major difference between SpaceX and Sierra Nevada Corporation. Both SpaceX's Dragon and Sierra Nevada Dream Chaser need to ride a launch vehicle into orbit, but SpaceX uses reusable Falcon launchers for this purpose, while Sierra Nevada doesn't build launch vehicles. Thus, Sierra Nevada will need to buy launchers from other companies in order to get Dream Chaser into orbit, adding to its cost. Currently, plans are for Sierra Nevada Corporation to purchase Atlas V rockets from United Launch Alliance for this purpose. But in 2016, Sierra Nevada then VP of Space Systems John Olson let on that Sierra Nevada was designing the space plane to be agnostic as to which launcher it uses to get into orbit. So in theory, at least, Sierra Nevada could use a SpaceX Falcon rocket to carry Dream Chaser instead. Because SpaceX's Falcons are cheaper than the expendable rockets used by other space launch companies, this would probably result in a lower launch cost for Sierra Nevada, and the cost could be even cheaper if it uses reusable Falcons. What it means for Sierra Nevada? Granted, this would necessitate giving money to a competitor. However, seeing as Sierra Nevada is going to have to buy its launch vehicles from somebody, it might as well buy them from the cheapest provider. And if it does so, this will almost certainly mean that not only SpaceX, but Nevada Corporation, too, can bid below what Northrop Grumman must charge to perform commercial resupply services supply missions for NASA, giving Nevada Corporation a leg up in future competitions to resupply International Space Station. What it means for Northrop Grumman and SpaceX. 6 months ago, defense contractor Northrop Grumman acquiring space launch company Orbital ATK in an all-cash $7.8 billion merger, Northrop took possession of Orbital's Minotaur and Antares medium lift rocket families. It acquired Orbital's ongoing project to build a new Omega-class heavy lift rocket as well, with which to compete against the likes of United Launch Alliance and SpaceX for large commercial and military satellite launches. Northrop Grumman also inherited Orbital's ongoing NASA contract to resupply crew aboard the International Space Station with needed consumables under the agency's Commercial Resupply Services contracts, missions valued at as much as $14 billion across the three companies hired to run them. Three companies won Commercial Resupply Services contracts to conduct supply runs to International Space Station, Orbital ATK, now owned by Northrop, SpaceX, and privately held Sierra Nevada Corporation. Dream Chaser could become a nightmare for Northrop Grumman and SpaceX. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe.